What's up, guys? Shane Starnes here, and something kind of strange happened to me yesterday that hasn't ever happened to me before. So a few days after the Pixel event where we were introduced to the Pixel 6 and the Pixel 6 Pro, I actually was inundated with text messages and phone calls from friends and family asking me if they should switch from the iPhone over to the Pixel 6 Pro. I thought it was strange that all of a sudden all of these iPhone users begin to ask me if they should switch to the Pixel 6 Pro. So why is that? Why are iPhone users all of a sudden interested in the new Pixel phone? We're gonna talk about that. Let's go ahead and get started. Okay, so the number one reason that I think that iPhone users are looking at the Pixel 6 and the Pixel 6 Pro is just pure iOS and iPhone exhaustion. So they're tired of the same thing year after year after year. So we're on like the fourth iteration of this triple camera design with the iPhone. And I think we had like the iPhone 13, the iPhone 12, the 11, the XR with the same basic design with a notch up front, the camera array in the back. So the design on the iPhone is getting a little stale, not to mention that the software itself hasn't seen much change in over a decade. So every year when a new iPhone comes out, I buy one for my wife, I get it all set up, I go and hand her her new iPhone, and she looks at me like, what is this? I thought you were giving me a new iPhone, because it's basically the same thing every single year. When it comes to the Pixel lineup, it's always been about software innovation. That's what Pixel has been known for. They've been known for really good cameras, really good software. They're innovating in places where other phone brands and manufacturers aren't. Most other manufacturers are focused on hardware. Google's not always been focused on hardware, but we finally have a true flagship with a flagship processor on a Pixel device. We have a flagship camera array. We have a flagship display. Everything about this phone is premium. So Apple's not the only one that's gotten super stale on the design of the phone. Samsung has gotten really stale on their designs. We're getting much of the same from Samsung. And Google's really stepping out here with the Pixel 6 Pro and the Pixel 6. When it comes to design, Google's not playing it safe. They're giving us something totally different here with the Pixel 6 and Pixel 6 Pro. We're getting that glossy back with a full camera bar, which features a telephoto lens, and they're not backing away from the camera bump. They're actually leaning into it, giving us a full camera update on that array. We're getting a 50 megapixel main camera, a 12 megapixel ultra wide camera, and a 48 megapixel telephoto camera, which gets that 4x zoom. And on the front, instead of that hideous notch that iPhone will not get rid of, in fact, they've incorporated it into their MacBook lineup, which is ridiculous. Instead of getting that awful notch, we get a hole punch camera, and the front of the phone just looks streamlined and totally advanced. We're also getting a display with high brightness mode and 120 megahertz refresh rate. So we're definitely getting a premium display, and we're getting an all new Tensor chip. So no longer is Google relying on Qualcomm. They're finally stepping up to the chip ball game here, and hopefully they're gonna knock it out of the park. Of course, I can't tell you much about the performance of this chip. That's gonna come later in the full review, but I like the fact that they're truly innovating and they're truly bringing something fresh and new to the market. And I think that is the main reason that iPhone users may be switching over to the Google Pixel 6 and Pixel 6 Pro. The second reason that I think that some iPhone users are switching, they're seeing that the Pixel 6 and 6 Pro are probably a much better value. So we're looking at a $599 phone for something that's similar to the iPhone 13 Pro, and we're looking at an $899 phone in the 6 Pro that's more similar to like an iPhone 13 Pro Max. So the 13 Pro Max is $1,100, so that's a $200 difference. But the big difference here is the $999 iPhone 13 Pro versus the $599 Pixel 6. The Pixel 6 Pro features double the RAM, almost 1,000 milliamp hours more of battery, and there's just a lot of things where you look at both phones and see that the Pixel 6 Pro is probably the better value. So like when they announced these prices, I kind of did a double take because I thought for sure Google was going to release the Pixel 6 Pro past $1,000, but I think they're really going for the value play here at $899, and I think that is one of the main reasons that they are attracting a lot of iPhone users. Not only is Google innovating with design and features and functionality over, you know, what iPhone's been doing for the past several years, not only are they bringing forth a better value. They're actually giving you more bang for your buck. But I think that Google is ready to really buckle down with their marketing campaign. So they've actually been marketing and advertising this device for the past several weeks, even before the major announcement. They've now seeded out, you know, over 1,000 units to influencers and people in the tech industry to hype up this phone and share it with you guys. Your average everyday Joe now knows that the Pixel exists. They know that it is comparable to the iPhone lineup, and they know that it is a better value. That's all thanks to Google's marketing department for actually pushing this phone out there and getting it in front of eyeballs before the official release. So I think that just the great job that the marketing team has done at pushing this out there and letting people know that it does exist and that it's comparable to what Apple's offering. So you're probably wondering, what did I tell my friends and family? Should they switch over from the iPhone? You know, look, if you were looking for something different, I know that Apple has their ecosystem going. Many of you are not gonna be able to let go of your iMessage and your FaceTime, but hey, just in case you didn't know, text messages and phone calls do exist. So if you are to switch over to Android, yes, you can still talk to your family members. There's applications like WhatsApp, there's GroupMe, there's all kind of applications that you can use to communicate between different devices, Android and iPhone. I've never really understood how people get so obsessed with iMessage and that ecosystem, but I think this is the year when iPhone users say, I've had enough, I actually want to go for something that's new and unique and different. And I think that a lot of iPhone users will be switching over to the Pixel 6 and the Pixel 6 Pro. What are your thoughts? Let me know below. Are you an iPhone user that's thinking of switching to the Pixel 6 and Pixel 6 Pro? Have you already made the switch? Let me know in the comments below. That about wraps it up for this one. Thanks guys for watching. Be blessed. I'll see you in the next one.